you're doing things right, you're wiser than before, you don't have to listen to your past self anymore. If a belief from times past is holding you back, reassess your situation, collect data, change track. While this analogy may not work for all, imagine a garden that starts very small. You plant trees by what you choose to consume, whether pictures or podcasts or gallons of porn alone in your room. As the tree grows, so do your tastes, your cares, your belief, and the thread of the fates. Choose carefully the trees you plant in your garden, and when you have a forest, it's time to start grafting.
I'm gonna experiment with this call.
Take clippings from your garden. With twine of mind, join branches together. A painting from Goya and irony from Alanis. A picture of Milo from the Disney film Atlantis. Just know, your tree needs good stable dirt with a mix of soil to help it take root. Steal from one and be labeled a thief. Steal from many, people look on in disbelief. Commandment 5, write down your idea. It's important and helps to keep the mind clear. Carry with you a method for writing. Ideas are as random and fickle as lightning. A phone works fine, a notepad too. Index cards might work well for you. Ideas aren't sticky, they are not glue. And when forgotten, they sail into the blue. Commandment 5, make every day. This one is simple and written that way. Commandment 6, maintain your vessel. While you, the captain, might see this as a hassle, you are but a brain in a big fucking mech. A machine that will break down if left unchecked. You must take care of your craft by going for walks. See your friends, have long talks. If that doesn't work, swimming will too. Just find something physical that you can do. It doesn't have to be hard, just something that suits you. Commandment 8. You are not born into destiny or fate. Though technically you are, because free will is a lie, but just ignore that and give something a try. Maybe you'll get a Wikipedia page when you die. Thinking on ideas gives time for fester and rot, which is what you'll achieve by mulling a lot. It's something called brain crack, as Zay Frank said it best. No matter how much you plan, you'll always have to do something for the first time. For example, a YouTube video spoken completely in Limerick. Zay called it an addiction, whether macaroni art, interpretive dance, or fiction. If you leave them too long, your ideas become an affliction. Commandment 9 deals with the divine. Save your damnation. That is for gods and certain immortal crustaceans. A human mind can hold only so much. Do not clog it with hatred for things you can't touch. Which brings me finally to Commandment 10. Writers of the past have told great tales. Artists that took to the sea with no sails, braved the waves, snow, wind, and hail. In time, however, their bones became frail, eyes sunk in, skin went pale. They'd write to past lovers who they hadn't seen in years, ink-stained hands, washed by their tears, waiting for reply, ravaged by fears. They'd take up the brush, and they'd make their feelings clear. This art was amazing. A sight to behold, but this tragedy, I'm sure you've been told. As before the work saw the light of day, this artist had passed away. It was maybe a gunshot or a self-inflicted wound, but only in death they became renowned. Through their whole sorry life, they suffered in vain, convincing themselves that it was more of a gain. And sure, sometimes great art comes from great pain, but you get to live once.
Because I certainly don't want to be addicted to brain crack.